Hi, I'm Hitesh from Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, and this is a brief summary of our recent work on role of temperature and metallicity in evolution of thermal instability. Our work was recently submitted to Archive and MNRS. This work involved me, Dr. Prakriti Pal Chaudhary, and Professor Pratik Sharma. So understanding multiphase gas in ICM and CGM is an important question, and one of the ways to create multiphase gas is through thermal instability. But there are questions about the cold phase of a multiphase gas, such as do they look like mist, or these are very dense spatially separated islands. And we try to answer such questions and find out how the structure of cold gas depends on the temperature and metallicity of the gaseous environment. So we start off with doing linear theory. We consider small scale and large scale perturbation limits, namely the isobaric and isochoric modes. We find that the growth in both limits has no explicit dependence on metallicity. We verify the linear theory using simulations in linear regime across a range of wave numbers. And we find that the agreement between the simulations and theory is quite good. We also find that the nonlinear evolution of isochoric clouds is different depending on the stability of the isochoric mode. That means linear response determines the nonlinear evolution. There have been previous studies on the nonlinear evolution of isochoric clouds. Makot et al. In 2018 proposed that an isochoric cloud will shatter into smaller isobaric clouds to attain faster pressure equilibrium, while another study by Waters and Proga in 2019 found that it is possible for the isochoric cloud to attain pressure equilibrium even without shattering. We see nonlinear evolution of both kinds depending on the stability. If the isochoric mode is unstable, the overdense regions cool monolithically, first to form large underpressured cooled regions that collapse transiently to form oscillating clouds of size CST cool, which later relax to the background pressure. But if the isochoric mode is stable, then smaller isobaric clouds grow within the isochoric cloud, which are then transiently of the size CST cool and later merge to form bigger clouds. So the conclusions from our study are that the thermal instability growth rate has no explicit dependence on metallicity. The linear response of the isochoric mode determines how the nonlinear evolution of the isochoric cloud will look like. And characteristic size of minimum CST cool is followed only in a transient phase, while the clouds can be much larger at later times as they merge and relax to the background pressure. Links to the article are included in the description. Thanks for your attention.